Change tracking is a real pain point in Dapper. Sometimes you will need it to improve performance of your updates. But you don't want to reinvent EF Core and create your own version of it on top of Dapper, don't you? So in this video, I will show you how you can create a very lightweight change tracker on top of Dapper, which will help you precisely in the place where you see performance issues without the need to generalize it into some heavyweight solution. Let me show you the code. This is an example of updating a complex entity. I'm first updating the root record in the database. Then I need to delete the child objects that do not exist in the in-memory entity anymore. And I need to walk through all the child objects and upsert them just in case that they were updated or inserted new. This is complicated. You will see when I run this application. This is the company entity which I am updating there. It has a list of address entities that belong to it, and those are the child objects that I must synchronize with the database. So I want to show you the SQL. This is the integration test that will add multiple addresses to a company. I will run it and it will pass. So let me show you what it really did. It's updating both fields in the company row, which is wasteful. I didn't even change the company. I added new addresses. It is then apparently deleting all addresses with IDs not belonging to what I can see in memory. This is totally wasteful because I didn't delete any addresses from the company. This statement will do nothing. And then come the update of the first address, passing all the values into the database, but it updates nothing because this is the new address, so I figure out there is nothing. I insert the address then. It's a total of 12 round trips to the database where actually I could do that with only one because I know precisely what is the change. It is the insert of 5 rows into the child table. Just to give you an idea what I mean, there is another implementation of the entire web API using EF Core here. This is what EF Core did. It inserted 5 addresses in one go. These are the 5 rows, picking values from the parameters, and all parameters for all properties of all 5 new addresses are in the parameters. It works like a charm in just one round trip to the database. This is what I want to have because supposedly we have discovered a performance bottleneck because of those endpoints that are updating companies in all kinds of ways. The answer to our problems is the change tracker, which does not come packed together with Dapper. This is the repository that knows nothing about the state of the entity before the update. I want something else. I want a tracking company's repository, which will implement the same repository, the command repository interface with 4 operations: finding by ID, adding, removing, and updating. It will require a database connection. I will skip transactions in this demo. It is an orthogonal concern, so to say. Don't laugh. Change tracking will be complicated enough for one demo. Here comes the central point. There will be a dictionary that maps an ID into the company entity. And this dictionary will remember the state of each company entity when it was loaded from the database. It will store original versions of each company entity. So I will be able to compare the new version with the original one to create optimal SQL statements. For example, finding an entity by ID would return the instance from the dictionary if available. But what if entity with this ID is not known to the dictionary? It's easy. Rely on a non-tracking repository to do the heavy lifting. Just delegate to that repository try to load the entity and store it in the dictionary before returning it. One important note here, if your models are mutable, you must clone them here. My domain model here in this demo is immutable, so I don't have to do it, but you will have to clone every mutable object before putting it into the dictionary. We move on to adding. It is trivial, delegate to the inner repo, but remember the object in the change tracker. Again, clone it if mutable. Delegate removal to the inner repo, but also stop tracking the entity. So far, everything was easy. The complexity begins here. If for some reason we don't have the entity in the tracker, which shouldn't happen, fall back to the inner repository and it will do it the old way. Otherwise, if nothing changed in the entity, which we check by comparing the two entities, return success in quit early. There is nothing to bother the database with because nothing changed in the object. Why generate any SQL code for that? And that brings us to the substance of updating a complex entity. There will be four stages in it. Change the fields of the row to row if required. Delete only those child rows that are missing. Insert those child rows that were added. And carefully update all child rows that contain changes. Each of these four stages must behave optimally. I will now implement these four methods. That is where all the complexity of this video will be. So please focus from this point on. It's going to be a wild ride, I promise you. But before that, let me mention you one detail. All the videos on this channel are free, but only thanks to the patrons, the people who support this channel on Patreon. If you like what you have learned from this video and all other videos on my channel, then please consider joining the growing community of patrons on my Patreon page. That will give you access to the entire source code of this video and all other videos on my channel, and some goodies that are not available on YouTube. I really appreciate all the help you are giving me. Thank you very much. Now let's get back to the demo, because some really nasty code is awaiting us. We'll start with updating the root row, which will be fairly straightforward, but tricky again. In the least, we need to fetch the database ID, but if the company entity itself was modified, then we will piggyback the ID fetching on the update operation on the company row. We're done with updating the root row. Let's get to child rows. That is where all the complexity will be. First, we need to delete all the missing addresses from the database. How do we know which addresses to delete? Compare the two entities, the new version and the original version fetched from that dictionary, and figure out by querying in memory which address rows are missing now. If nothing is missing, then quit early. Don't go to the database. Otherwise, construct an optimal delete statement which only lists the IDs that should really be deleted. Execute it, and that's it. Deleting was still easy. But now we get to inserting, which will be the most complicated operation here. First of all, we need to isolate the entire address objects with public IDs that do not exist in the original entity. This is it. If the list is empty, quit early and do not waste database resources. Otherwise, put all the new objects into the same SQL insert and pass them all together into the database. You will do that by creating the dynamic parameter set and a dynamically built SQL insert statement. Loop through all the added addresses. Add one row to the values clause in the insert statement. Then add each property individually to the set of parameters, also using the index to make them unique. Don't forget to set the foreign key, which is the same for all addresses. And this is basically it. You can condense SQL code by giving short names to parameters, eventually execute the entire SQL and pass all parameters together. All right, updating addresses is the last operation to implement. First, discover all address objects that exist in both entities but differ among each other. Each modified address will require one round trip to the database, but we don't want to update all the fields. I will build a list of properties that have truly changed. I will build the dynamic parameter set. Finally, I will construct the update statement with the set clause, which only contains the updated fields. And this finally completes the repository implementation with change tracking. There is one change required before I can run the test again. It is dependency injection. Look, here is where I have registered the traditional repository for companies. I will use the tracking repository now. Let's run that integration test again. The test has passed. You can see that it's only fetching the database ID for the company because there are no changes to the fields in the company's row. And here is the only insert statement that was sent. There are values for all five addresses, each property of each of them, all added in one SQL statement. I made only 2 round trips to the database instead of 13 as I did originally. Let me show you one more test. This one is modifying the address. I'm running it. There are 7 test cases. All 7 are passing. But each test case is updating only one field in one address. Only updating the zip code. All other fields are simply missing. Another one only updates the city, leaving all other fields unchanged. It is all thanks to this new repository, which I have implemented, which contains a very lightweight implementation of the change tracker. Make it work, make optimal SQL statements for the database, but do not, under any circumstances, develop a full solution because you will end up reinventing EF Core. That just doesn't pay the bills. I hope you'll find this useful in your daily work.